Okay, so we are going to do a show banding. This is what I have been trained and what I have found has worked for me. Different dogs might require different banding styles. So what I start with is making my bubble part. I'm going to go corner of the eye, straight to corner of the eye. I don't find that you need too much hair for your bubble. And so I just go corner of the eye to corner of the eye. So about what we've got, a nice straight line. Some people will round it. I just go straight across, and then I'm using yellow band so it's easier to see. I'm just going to band that section. And we're going to ignore that for now. We're not going to pull the bubble until later. And then I like to do two sections before the ear, kind of right in the middle, between there. Making sure you always do a nice straight line, do approximately the same distance. Don't get your bubble hair in there. He's got a bit of broken hair here. I'm just going to ignore. If I was doing him for show, I would try to pull those in as much as I could, but they're pretty short. Now, I've never done switches, so I'm not the biggest help, but to my knowledge, what you want to do is kind of part the hair and then put the switch right down into the center so that the switch is hidden amongst the hair. Hang on, I'm just gonna lift this there. Okay. So if you were going to do a switch, that is, to my knowledge, the way that you're going to do it. I haven't done it before, though, so don't take my word as gospel. And with show bands, you can put them in tighter than three wraps around, which normally you wouldn't do it for a maintenance band. But so far, we've got the two sections done. So now we're going to do a section just in front of the ears. Again, if you need spray, I really like the Crown Royal spray. I don't find that it relieves a residue, which could weigh the hair down and make it more difficult to deal with. So I'm doing the part just in front of the ears. Again, you're always wanting to go for that straight line. Making sure that you go right to the ear, but that you do not include any ear hair into your banding, because otherwise it's just going to be very uncomfortable for the dog and they're going to be shaking their head going around the ring, which isn't going to look very nice to the judge. About the phone call. Okay, just one second. Okay. So this is currently what we've got. Three sections, the bubble section, and then two in front of the ear. And now we're going to do a section from the last banding that you did until pretty much right at the occiput. So you're going just over the ear. Again, you don't want any ear hair in your bands. So I'll do the same thing here. I like this comb, it's just a nice, easy comb to use. Sorry, I didn't brush out his ears yet. Had me. So, got your straight line there. And I'm just taking it right at the occiput, straight across. Okay, let me clear off. Okay, so, straight line right at the occiput. Everything in. Again, if you're getting static, just use a bit of spray. And we're going to band this section. Try and keep your dog from eating your other sections. So if you need to toss band in there, which I will in just a second, but I'm going to show you this first. So this is what we currently have. Again, you want to make sure that's not going to be pulling on your ear, so you can loose it a touch by your ear. Just because, again, if they're uncomfortable, they're going to be shaking. So, to keep this hair out of the way, I didn't even wrap it around, I just put it on once. And now, I'm going to have to go to the opposite side that I normally would. But I'm going to, that was a very straight. I'm going to part the hair again, trying to kind of get all the long hair on this section, and again on the other side, and then I'm just going to come straight across here. Now the rule is that you don't have bands past your occiput, but when this is all sprayed up, if you pull it forward, and this is sprayed up and you pull this section forward, because the occiput is here, and you pull this forward and it's all sprayed up, then this is going to be sitting right on your occiput. So now that I've got this, this is the part that I find the trickiest, and I'm sure there's a better way to do it, but I'm not there yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to gather all the hair and all the ears, because I want to put on his collar. You could do this when you've got your maintenance bands in there before you start banding. But he didn't have any maintenance bands in because he just had a bath. But I'm going to pull his collar all the way up and sit it right where I have this last section. And then I'm going to drop again when I'm not using head. And I'm going to comb up this section again. And then I'm going to just take a little section from behind the collar. So you can see that. See how the collar goes through, comes up the other side. And that is just going to help hold your collar in place, because you always want that collar right up behind the ear. So we're going to band this section, and this is about what we've got. We've got this band at the back, and then we've got One, two, three, four, the front. Again, we haven't touched this bubble yet. So you can either pull your bubble now or you can start connecting them. Normally I would be on this side of him, but I've got my camera set up there, so I'm gonna have to be on the opposite side, which will be a little bit weird. So now we've got who connect. Sorry, dog hair. Connect them together. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this back section and we're gonna take a little piece from it. And we're going to take a little piece from the section in front of it. And we're going to band these two together. And when I do that, I'm going to pull this other section up a bit because I want to be pulling it forward. And again, you can do your banding more times, especially doing a small piece like this. And if you need to, you can tighten it up as well. So now we've got a section from this, a section from this, banded together in the middle. And you're gonna do the same thing with this one. You're going to take a section from this one, and a section from this one. Band those together. Sorry, there's a big wad of hair on that one. And again, you're going to pull it forward a little bit. And you want these to sit fairly tight to help hold things in place. Now, before obviously we connect, we still got one more section. Sorry, I'm eating a lot of dog hair today. So, again, you're going to do the same thing. Whether you do bigger sections or smaller sections can depend on, you know, how much hair you've got and that kind of thing. So, section from there, section from there, and we're going to band those together. I would assume if you've got wiggies in that you're going to want to not band the actual wiggies in case you start pulling them out or something. But again, I have personally not done the wiggies. So we've got that. And now, before we band this front section, we want to pull this bubble. So I'm just going to toss these up here so hopefully you can see. And we're going to remove this. Again, I like to use these letter opener thingies just because I tried to use one of those band cutting scissors the other day and it just did not work for me. All right, I'm going to try and move this to the front. Okay. So, what I like to do, first of all, this I tend to take a comb with a smaller front teeth just so you can get it really smooth. It's got a couple of eye goobers. But then I part it kind of in the middle. And then, so I parted this front bubble piece in the middle. Then I'm just gonna do just a touch of back combing. This isn't the best comb to do it with, but just to create just a little bit of extra volume, but then you wanna make sure that your front section is still smooth. And then I'm gonna pull it all together. Again, he's got loose pieces that if I was showing, I would try to fixed out, but I'm going to pull it pretty close to the front of his head rather than putting it where it should go. I'm going to put it right right at the front. And then I'm going to stick my finger in between his eyeballs and grab the very back of this thing, and I'm going to pull it back. This helps to tighten it at the back as well as sort of start your bubble. And then you're going to grab in between his eyeballs and you're just going to pull that section out. Now this can take some playing. Usually I give myself 3 tries to get it, and if I don't get it, or if I, whatever I have on the 3rd try is kind of what you go with, because it can take forever to play around with this. And I'm going to do it tighter this time up by his skull because it was a little bit loose. He's being a little bit of a pain. And I'm going to pull it back. And then I'm going to grab the back section, pinch between his eyeballs, and just pull it out. And then you just kind of play around with it. Some people like to use their combs to help them out. You want to pull on the back kind of hair to kind of scrunch it down a little bit. Not the most perfect bubble, but you get kind of the idea. Hopefully you can see that. I know the lighting isn't the best. But again, you just kind of pick around with it until you've got it. And just kind of give you a good expression. He's a little bit tight through here. So that's that. And again, we're going to take out this band that I just had holding things. And now instead of taking a little section here, I'm going to take the whole section. And I'm going to take hair from this last section. And then you want to make sure you're not pulling it back. So if you pull it back, you see what happens to your bubble. It just goes up. So you kind of want to pull it more forward. And don't do it too tight. And again, I always find I have to pull the bubble down a little bit again, going behind and pushing it in. And so that is kind of roughly what I personally do for my show banding. So I've got the bubble band, then 1, 2, 3, this is the bigger one, 4, which again, when you pull it forward, that's now sitting kind of right on the occiput. And then we've connected them. We've got connected here, connected in the middle here, and connected here. And the big one at the front, where you take that whole front section and connect it to the one behind it. So that is roughly how I do my show bands, but obviously I do them in black. But for ease of you guys seeing it, I did it in yellow today.